Welcome. Remote Logging, Telnet. The main task of the internet is to provide services for its users, and most popular applications include remote logging, electronic mail, and file transfer. In this video, I am going to discuss about remote logging. Remote logging means we are logging into a remote machine and we can work there as if we are working on our own local system. So, in the internet also we have to implement such remote logging, or we have to run application programs at a remote site and create results that can be transferred to local site. One way to solve this situation is to create separate client server application program for each of the services we need. However, creating separate programs for separate services is very difficult. So, a better solution is a general purpose client server program, which can let the user access any application program on the remote computer. Telnet. Telnet is a general purpose client server application program which is used for remote logging. Telnet means terminal network. It is the standard TCP/IP protocol for virtual terminal services and is proposed by ISO. Time sharing environment. Before going into the details of Telnet, we must know about a time sharing environment, when it was developed, etc. Actually, Telnet was designed at a time when most of the operating systems were operating in a time sharing environment, such as Unix. In a time sharing environment, a large computer supports multiple users and the time is divided among these users. The interaction between a user and a computer occurs through a terminal. Terminal in the sense a combination of keyboard, monitor and a mouse. Means actually a user is using a terminal, a dumb terminal, and he is logging into a server, remote server located somewhere, and he is working as if he is working in his own system. Even a microcomputer can simulate a terminal with a terminal emulator. Logging. You know, when you try to start using a system, mostly it will prompt for a username and a password. Actually, the username and password serves as the identification for the user. It determines whether the user is an authorized user or not. Thus, in order to use a system or access a system, the user logs into the system with the user ID or the login name and the password. This is only for preventing unauthorized user from accessing the resources. So this figure shows a local login. Here we have a terminal, and in the operating system we have software known as terminal driver, and terminal driver will make us to communicate with different application programs. And here is a figure showing remote login. Here also we have the terminal and the terminal driver, and as it is remote login and we are using telnet, this side, outside, we will say as telnet client. The program is working and the terminal driver communicate with telnet client, and as it is TCP IP oriented, with the help of that TCP IP protocol suite over the internet, this connection request will be passed to the remote machine to which we want to get connected. So there also there also we have something known as telnet server and the pseudo terminal driver. With the help of this telnet server and pseudo terminal driver, we can get access to these remote applications. Thus we are actually sitting here in our local system or local terminal and getting connected to this remote terminal, or we are accessing these remote applications with the help of telnet. Now comes virtual terminal. So while dealing with remote login, we are logging into a remote system, and for that we must know what type of computer we are going to connect to. Also we must install the specific terminal emulator used by that remote system. This is too difficult, and Telnet solved this problem by defining a universal interface called NVT or Network Virtual Terminal Character Set. And this figure shows the concept of NVT, Network Virtual Terminal. This is our terminal at the client side, and here is the client, Telnet client. So whenever the client means we are making some request for remote login, it is received by the Telnet client and it will be converted to a character set, that is NVT character set, while sending it over the internet. At the client side it is using the local computer character set, whatever it is there it is using, and over the internet it is transmitted using NVT character set. This NVT character set data or request reaches the telnet server at the remote machine to which we are trying to connect, and this telnet server at the remote machine will transform the NVT character set into the character set of that system, of that remote system. So this is how actually NVT works. And in this NVT character set we have data character as well as control character, and all these bits except the first bit are same. For a data character, first bit is 0, and for a control character the first bit is 1. So once again, the client telnet translates characters, that is data or commands, into NVT form and delivers them to the network and the server telnet translates data and command from the MVT form into a form acceptable by the remote computer. Now coming to MVT character set, as I told, there are two sets of characters, one for data and one for control. Both these are of 8 bits. Some of NVT control characters are given. You can just go through this. Embedding. Basically, Telnet uses only one TCP connection. The server uses the well-known port 23. That is for the server. Telnet uses well-known port number 23. The client also, as it is using TCP/IP, TCP connection, we know that this process-to-process communication is taking place. Or here we have this Telnet client to Telnet server, process-to-process communication is taking place. So we need two port numbers, one for the sender and one for the receiver. And I told you now that server uses the well-known port number 23. And what about the client? The client uses an ephemeral port. We have already discussed about this, that it is a port number defined by the client. It can be discussed by any system, and it is chosen randomly by the transport layer software running in the client. Actually, ephemeral port numbers are temporary port numbers. Once use is over, it is released. And this same connection is used, TCP connection is using, and this same TCP connection is used for both, used for sending both data and control characters. So how is it possible? Telnet accomplishes this by embedding the control characters in the data stream. That is, control characters are embedded or maybe inserted in the data stream. And in order to differentiate between the control characters and data characters, the sequence of control characters is preceded by a special control character called IAC, that is interpret as control. Upon seeing this IAC, the receiver can identify that it is a control character. The coming is a control character. Options. Telnet allows the client and server to negotiate options before or during the use of the service. So many services are there. So before and also during the use of a service, client and the server can negotiate options. And what is this options means? Actually, options are extra features available to users. So normally, with simpler terminals, we can use default features. So in addition to these default features, there are some additional features, and these are mentioned as options. Options are binary, echo, suppress, go ahead, status, timing mark, terminal time, terminal speed, and line mode. We can explain these options one by one. So first one is binary. This allows the receiver to interpret every 8-bit character received as binary data. A except IAC. Interpret IAC means interpret as control. So control characters are not treated as or interpreted as binary data. All other characters except control characters are interpreted as binary data if we are using the binary option. And when IAC is received, the next character or characters are interpreted as commands only. And if two consecutive IAC characters are received, the first is discarded and the second is interpreted as data. The similar situation have been discussed in data link layer framing. So we can compare this with that framing. When the control characters DLE also appears in data accidentally, okay, we can refer to that. Echo. So you know what is echo. This option allows the server to echo data received from the client. That is, the client sends something, the server will send back the same thing, that is echo. Actually, every character sent by the client to the server will be echoed back to the screen of the client terminal. That is, whenever we are typing something and it is displayed on the client screen, it is actually echoed by the server. Normally, the user terminal does not echo characters when they are typed, but waits until it receives them from the server. Suppress go ahead. This option suppresses the go ahead character. So particular character is it is given in the list, and this can be suppressed. Status. This allows the user or the process running on the client machine to get the status of the options being enabled at the server side. So we are talking about the options, and basically we can use the default without options. And if we are using options, all these options need not be set or need not be enabled. So while the user or the process is process on the client machine wants to get the status, it can inquire about this. Timing mark. This allows one party, can be the client or the server, to issue a timing mark that indicates all previously received data has been processed. It can be compared with acknowledgement that we have already learned. So there is a timing mark, and it indicates that till that timing mark all data has been received and properly processed. Terminal type. This option allows the client to send its terminal type to the server. Terminal speed used by the client to send its terminal speed. Next, line mode. This allows the client to switch to the line mode. There are different types of modes, and which we will discuss it later in this session. So next is option negotiation. I told you just now that these options need not be set previously. The user can use default mode, default, that is without any option. And if we want to use the options, there can be, or first we have to make an option negotiation between the client and the server. And one interesting feature of Telnet is its symmetric option negotiation. That means the client and the server are given equal opportunity. Either the client or the server can set the options, and they have equal chance. They have equal chance for setting it. So as I told, at the beginning of the connection, it is assumed that both sides are using default Telnet implementations with no options enabled. And if one party, can be the client or the server, wants to enable an option, it can offer a request. And the other party has the right to approve the offer or reject the request. And rejection, under normal conditions, a request is rejected only if the party is not capable of using the option, or it does not want to use the option. In this situation, under normal conditions, it will not get rejected, and otherwise, the other party must not be able to use that option, or it doesn't want to use it at that time. Now coming to mode of operation, most Telnet implementations operate in any one of the following modes: default mode, character mode, line mode. We can check it one by one. Default mode. This mode is used if no other modes are invoked through option negotiation. That is, we are using the default thing. No option is used, or no option negotiation is done. In this mode, the echoing, that is echoing for the purpose of displaying the type matter on the client's screen. Echoing is done by the client. The user types a character and the client echoes, the Telnet client echoes the character on the screen or a printer, whatever it is, but does not send it until the whole line is complete. Character mode. In this mode, each character type is sent by the client to the server. That is, each character type is sent by the client to the server. In the case of default mode, the client itself echoes the character on the screen, and it will not send until whole line is completed. Whereas in character mode, each character type is sent by the client to the server, and the server normally echoes this character back to the client, and it is displayed on the client's screen. And the problem related to this character mode is that the echoing of the character can be delayed if the transmission time is too long. So if something is to be displayed on the user's screen, it will take much time, or a time gap will be there. It also creates overhead traffic for the network, because 3 TCP segments must be sent for each character of data. Next is line mode. This is considered as the best mode, and is proposed to compensate for the deficiencies of the default mode and character mode. In this, line editing, that means echoing, character erasing, means character editing, character erasing, line erasing, etc. Everything is done by the client. And once this is over, the client sends the whole line to the server. Hence the name line mode. Security issue. Telnet suffers from security problems. At the lowest level, Telnet requires a login name and a password. As you know, the use of a simple username and password or login name and password does not ensure security over the internet. Even that means a system, a computer connected to a LAN or the internet will suffer from attacks, password stealing, etc. So this is a major problem of Telnet. Thank you.